DJ, this is the first time here on World Organization Wrestling. We have had the opportunity to see him, Tom Boogaloo Chef. And he seems to be in very good condition. He's in good condition. And also at ringside is Turbo Ted. I wonder what he's presenting this evening.
Well, beginning of the matches here, Turbo Ted holds a contract with Boogaloo. And also holds contract with Pat Rose, Cary Booth, former members of Bob Sweetan's Bomb Squad. And now it all becomes clear as to what Turbo Ted had been up to the past 3 or 4 weeks, coming in there and trying to make peace between the Bomb Squad and Bob Sweetan. All along, Turbo Ted obviously had plans of his own to take these wrestlers over.
I understand that. You see, it seems though that Turbo Ted also have vacated the Bomb Squad.
That's right.
What have you, and perhaps he's going to, you know, take over this position.
Back to the ring here, and Boogaloo Shaft has got things all his way against the Patriot. Big man in Boogaloo Shaft. Got the armbar on the Patriot. Danny Barlow, your referee, is asking if the Patriot wants to give it up.
This is Tom Boogaloo Shaft, a former Mississippi and Louisiana state champion.
Look at that. Whoa. Boogaloo Shaft is just cleaning up on the Patriot. Got that headlock now. Last time we saw the Patriot here, Papa Rock, I said we had a new face. Obviously, we have a new mask.
Yeah, that's true. And I'm wondering about this Tom Boogaloo Shaft, you know. I understand that he, in some manner, are challenging Bob Sweetan also, isn't he?
That's right.
You say he's the man that is able to get the job done?
That's what the wrestler claims.
Right now, I believe that he's going to be able to live up to those potentials.
Well, farther on down the road here on World Organization Wrestling, that would be quite a match. Bob Sweetan against this Boogaloo Shaft. And right now, he's got the Patriot in all kinds of trouble. He's just burying some kicks into the back of the Patriot. And the Patriot is in not good shape at all. And the Patriot is trying to fight back. But those shots don't seem to be making too much effect on Boogaloo Shaft. Oh, the Patriot telegraphed that move.
And from the ringside, you can hear Terry Boutet hollering and giving Tom Boogaloo Shaft a whole lot of encouragement. So undoubtedly, Turbo Ted have something going here.
Boogaloo Shaft, oh, tremendous move there on Shaft's part, and he takes the Patriot to a 3 count. Your winner here on World Organization Wrestling. Well, the winner of the last match, Boogaloo Shaft, wasted no time in dispatching of the Patriot.
Let me tell you one thing, Mr. TV announcer. The Patriot was a tough guy. I eliminated one of them low-down dirty flag carrier suckers. Now, Sweetan, you're going to be the next one. But what you going to make me do? You're going to make them have to put me in jail for doing something really bad to you. That people calling me a bald-head geek. But let me tell you something. My name is Too Tough Tom Shaft. I'm 282 pounds. I'm not your truly walking brown eye, a sugar-coated, sweet loving, hugging soul. I got more love for that sweet Jean and Van Camp ever dreamed of having poking beans. I'm 58 inches across my chest, and I don't feel nothing but the good Lord in there. If I eat lightning, clap thunder, walk through the grave, I put the dead on the wonder. This is where the whole world don't start a rooting and shooting. There won't be no cutting and shooting. Don't start no swimming and sliding. There won't be no ambulance driving. Like I said one time, I said 1 million. I'm so doggone bad in front of myself. I ain't cut me when I do wrong. I ain't razor blade biscuit. I chew bubble gum. Anything the whole world can't stand. Then please do bring me some. You see the people out in bald head geek? They think they're going out and be loved by me tonight. But let me tell you something, baby. You just don't fit. You're not in sixth class. You gotta be number one class to fit with Tom Elstar Boogaloo Shell, which is known in the world as the Red Blood Shaker.
If you earn that $5,000 on Sweetan's head, that's right. I'm giving $5,000 to anybody that can put Sweetan out of the business. That's right, out of the wrestling business. Get him out of this World Organization Wrestling area.
Wait just one cotton picking minute. Did I use that $5,000? Well, I'll whoop my mama for $5,000. I'll whoop my daddy. I'll whoop my wife. I'll whoop my children. I'll hurt. I'll whoop anybody sucker for $5,000. Because let me tell you something. Money's what I'm after, and money's what I'm going to get. And I had plenty of women. I got one sweet woman now. I know I'm going to walk on off here. I'm going to do the thing I said I'm going to do.
Okay. We're going to take a commercial break. We'll be back with more action on World Organization Wrestling.
Oh, darling.
Imagine a moment of magic. Imagine a moment of pride.
How could she afford a ring like that?
Well, stop imagining. Enjoy the magic and the pride when you wear the fabulous 5-carat cubic zirconium Princessa evening ring. Yes, 5 carats. How can you afford it? Because during this limited time offer, your price is not the small fortune you might expect, but only $9.95. And here's a special bonus. We'll give you this matching Princessa pendant for the same low price.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-468-2700. Save COD charges by using your Visa or MasterCard, or mail $9.95 to 5-carat ring, box 606, Pensacola, Florida. Or call now 1-800-468-2700.
When I was first asked to do a television show with Gene Siskel, my original reaction was, the show sounds like a great idea, but why do I have to do it with Gene?
Yeah, I just had to beat him. That was the main thing. I didn't care about anything else.
He occasionally tells me what I think, and he is only occasionally right.
He persists in thinking that he's a better film critic than I am. Drives me crazy.
For the critical difference, it's Siskel and Ebert and the movies.
Sunday night at 6:30 on TV 44. It's Elvis Week on WJTC-TV's Feature 44. Beginning Monday night at 7, when Elvis takes you to a clam bake. Then Wednesday night, he's got to live a little and love a little. Thursday night, he's dodging cars and girls in Spin Out. And poor Elvis has double trouble when he gets mixed up in a jewelry theft Friday night. So make your plans to enjoy Elvis Week, beginning on Monday night's Feature 44 at 7 o'clock.
The music for the Golden Boy.
The Golden Boy, Jim Donovan, making his grand entrance. Fans love it. One of the finest built young men in the wrestling business today. One of the top-ranked heavyweights in the World Organization Wrestling, CJ.
Doing his thing there, right?
I never could get a pair of tights fit me like that, CJ. You know what? This guy's a favorite everywhere he goes. I guarantee you he's a favorite.
Chick Donovan.
Chick Donovan waiting
California.
On his opponent. A big guy coming to the ring, CJ.
Some new wrestlers here.
This young man, his name is Miles Bishop. Hails from over around Foley in Robertsdale, Alabama. A pretty good sized young man. He's about 6'4", weighs about 280 or 90 pounds. Former football player, just getting started in the professional wrestling business. And I don't know, CJ, what his experience is, to be honest with you. I haven't had that much dealings with him, but I do know that he's a pretty good sized boy. Looks like Chick Donovan is coming back on him. Irish whip in the rope and a big elbow.
Well, if he hasn't the experience that Chick Donovan has,
big hip toss.
He's going to get himself one heck of an education here.
Drag. Down to an arm bar.
Chick Donovan going to work.
Two count. Well, I'll tell you what, CJ, World Organization Wrestling has got more going on. the feud between Bob Holly and Pat Rose has gotten bad. And Krupoff and Sweetan are going to wind up hurting each other before it's over with. Might mention at this time, CJ, that Bob Holly suffered a bad cut on his head in Pensacola Sunday night, this past Sunday night, and required 8 or 9 stitches to close the place. And Holly is so mad now at Pat Rose that we're having trouble restraining him, even here in the wrestling studio. So this feud is getting out of hand. And Krupoff and Sweetan's got down to the point where one of them's got to go. Chick Donovan picked him up a new tag team partner in Huggy Bear Brown, and I've seen him a couple of times, CJ, and they're a one whale of a tag team combination.
Well, I tell you, that's a load out there. Chick Donovan's wrestling a little unorthodox.
Well, I'll tell you something. When you're as big as this guy, you can be anything you want to be. But he's in there with one of the best in the business. He dropped back to miss part of that drop kick, and he didn't catch a blunt of it. He got up too quick. Another arm drag.
Chick Donovan.
Chick's taking care of him in pretty good style. Hanging on that arm. I don't know a whole lot about Miles Bishop. I know that he's working out, and he's really, really wanting a future in the wrestling business. And if he does, CJ, this may be his opportunity to find out whether he really wants the wrestling business or not. What an unorthodox move.
Yeah.
And Donovan came out to a loser on that. He dropped his throat across the rope. His throat hit the bottom rope. Chick Donovan's in trouble, CJ. Might take this opportunity to mention to you fans in Mobile, World Organization Wrestling will be returning to Expo Hall in Mobile August the 18th. Tuesday night, August the 18th, we'll be returning to Mobile, Alabama, to Expo Hall. There will be some new ticket prices, and we'll make announcements of that later on in the program. Looks like Miles Bishop has got Chick Donovan Island.
Here comes Chick.
Throwed a couple old haymakers there then. Got the arm bar. Crazy Mike Diamond is out here walking around the ring.
Right.
Just walking around in front of the people. I have no idea what he's doing out here. Apparently, Donovan hasn't even seen him yet.
Unpredictable. Crazy Mike Diamond. And during this match, Chick Donovan just takes an elbow.
Donovan took a big elbow then.
Oh,
another big old elbow down.
Load.
Won't take too many of them to do you in.
Oh,
another
no.
elbow, and that one's across the kidneys.
Not from a wrestler the size of Miles Bishop. Big wrestler in there, into the turnbuckle.
This Miles Bishop surprised me.
Oh,
and he dropped the whole leg, 280-something pounds, across Chick Donovan's back.
Got Donovan and where he wants him.
He dropped it across his back.
Going for
Chick Donovan hurt.
Cover.
One count, and he kicked out.
Chick Donovan's got to get some reserve. Got to get some kind of thing going here.
I'll tell you something, CJ. When you weigh as much as this Miles Bishop weighs, and you're big as he is, Donovan's blocking the suplex. He blocks it again.
Yeah. Oh, nice move by Chick Donovan.
What a move. Donovan's got it geared up now.
Chick Donovan reaching down, starts to lay him in, Miles Bishop. Head into the turnbuckle. Oh, and one across the neck, the chop. Another one into the turnbuckle.
Oh, man, he whacked him into that turnbuckle in, CJ.
Here goes Chick Donovan going for a suplex. Oh, and a forward.
Gourd buster dropped it right on his noggin.
Three counts.
And the winner, Chick Donovan.
There's your winner, Chick Donovan.
Oh, and Crazy Mike Diamond jumped into the ring.
Well, that answers that question, Rip.
What he was doing out there now, maybe he's not as crazy as he lets on. Donovan caught him with a haymaker then. Donovan got him. Wonder what Mike Diamond thinks he's doing out here to begin with, coming in on this match.
Donovan slings him into the ring. Oh, he didn't miss that one. Oh! Took the full force of a truck.
I bet Mike Diamond's going to wish he hadn't come out here for this, though, Wes. They're continuing to ring the bell, trying to put a stop to it. I don't know what... CJ. We got a cut here for an interview, CJ. I don't know. Here comes Wild Man Fargo's coming to the ring now. And Donovan hadn't seen him. He's got a belt in his hand.
No!
And he whacked Dick Donovan with that belt.
Wild Man Don Fargo's in there. Oh, no.
We're going to have to get somebody out here to get this straightened up.
We got to get that referee in there.
Let me see if I can't get somebody, CJ, to get this under control.
Meanwhile, Wild Man Don Fargo, Crazy Mike Diamond. Diamond just takes the referee and throws him off. Off the ring. Canvas onto the concrete floor. And they are just unloading on Chick Donovan. And here comes some help in Huggy Bear Brown.
The right man in, CJ. We got a break for an interview right now. We're going to take this break and we'll be right back with more World Organization Wrestling. All right, wrestling fans, Pensacola Municipal Auditorium downtown, beautiful downtown Pensacola, bell time at 8:30. World Organization Wrestling presents a terrific card at the Municipal Auditorium on Sunday night. Main event, Boris Krupoff versus Bruiser Bob Sweetan. The loser must leave town. 10 rounds of boxing, Huggy Bear Brown versus Wild Man Don Fargo. U.S. Heavyweight title match, Pat Rhodes versus Bob Holly. TV title match, Marcel Pringle versus Dennis Gale. And one of the matches that Turbo Ted is standing here with me now and very interested in, the Coastal Connection versus Tom Boogaloo Chef and Tommy Bryant. This is Turbo Ted's new edition. And Ted, I know that you got a $5,000 bounty out on Sweetan. You're hoping Krupoff will run him out of town and you won't have to pay this bounty. Is that right?
That's correct. But let me tell you fans something. I want you all to come on out to Pensacola Municipal Auditorium and see Bob Sweetan. Wave goodbye to all of you because he's going to be leaving town. Because Boris Krupoff, my number one man from the Pride of Russia, is going to beat him and he's going to have to leave. And my man here, right here, the one is, if that don't happen, which I know it will anyways, Tom Schaff is going to have the Coastal Connection with a partner of his, and he's got a few things to say along with it.
I sure do. You know, I don't talk much, but I want to say one thing to you. I hope my man, Krupoff, or whatever his name, don't beat the guy, because I don't want him out of town. Bob Sweetan, I want you, because I want to send you back across the water on some boat with no sides, where the sharks will be biting at your feet, because let me tell you something, boy, for $5,000, I'll wake up my dead grandmama, and I'll slap her, and I'll slap her, and I'll slap my granddaddy, and you know darn well, I'll slap you and yours, and don't you ever forget it. People come out and come down to the Municipal Auditorium, or Tom L. Sop, Boogaloo Chef, gonna be doing some boogie-woogie down there.
We're back, wrestling fans. World Organization Wrestling.
DJ, notice the t-shirt that Cary Booth got on. It says, Sweet Tan. No Sweet Tan.
It's a Sweetan Buster shirt. Former Music. Member of the Bomb Squad, Cary Booth. Yeah. Former member, I might add.
And you know who's coming now, don't you?
Oh-ho!
The old boss man of the Bomb Squad. Making his entrance now to the ring. Bruiser Bob Sweetan to the music, born in the USA.
Yeah.
never seen fans take to a man as fast as they've taken to Bob Sweetan, and I can't understand it to save my soul. And he's not wasting any time on Cary Booth, and there goes the T-shirt.
There goes the shirt. Oh, man! Oh, Sweetan is just unloading.
Cary Booth's outside. Bob Sweetan's going after him and not wasting any time about it. I don't think Turbo Ted's too happy.
No. Sweetan wants a piece of Ted and Cary Booth.
I'll tell you something, this thing between Sweetan and Krupoff has almost got to be a nation battle, I'll tell you that.
I've never seen Bob Sweetan more motivated.
Well, Sweetan's a man now with a plan, I can tell you that. I've known this man for a lot of years,
yeah,
and watched him wrestle, and I've never seen him go after anybody like he has this Krupoff and this bomb squad.
Bob
he is
Sweetan
seriously after him.
Just Cary threw Booth Cary Booth off the...
He's inviting Turbo Ted in the ring now. And I don't think Turbo Ted will ever make that mistake.
Turbo Ted telling Cary Booth to get back in there. Sweetan is just putting a tremendous physical punishment on Cary Booth. Oh!
If he don't tear that shoulder out, I don't know why. He's ripping at Cary Booth and tormenting Turbo Ted at the same time, CJ.
Bob Sweetan.
I'd like to say once more while Sweetan's in the ring with Cary Booth, for our fans in the Dothan, Panama City area, for you people over in the Mississippi, Gulfport, Biloxi, Hattiesburg, World Organization Wrestling is coming your way in the very near future. If you'd like more information about when we're coming and all, please feel free to write us here at the office. The address is at the end of the program, and just copy it down and write to CJ or myself or anybody here at World Organization Wrestling, and we'll give you as many details as possible.
Bob Sweetan got Cary Booth's arm and shoulder going one way and his neck going another. Sweetan looks like he's dropped some weight and he's just mean.
Sweetan's losing weight. I don't know what he's living with a new a vengeance, I think. The man, like I told you, I have never seen a man after anybody like he's after Krupoff. I sometimes wonder if just this USA thing was the whole thing, or maybe he knew Krupoff was busting up the bomb squad, or Krupoff had gone behind his back. I don't think, to be honest with you, we've heard the whole story about that, and we may not ever hear it. But I'll say one thing, the fans are getting the results of it, and that's what counts when they come down and pay their money and get a ringside seat. I'll tell you what, Sweetan is the only one I've seen slow Krupoff down.
Yes. Oh,
right now he's got Cary Booth slowed way down. Turbo Ted's like a fly. He's fixing to get the fly trap here in a few minutes, not going to be able to get out.
Bob Sweetan just eating up Cary Booth.
You know, he's pulling a vengeance to get every bomb squad member one at a time on TV, and he's starting off with Cary Booth. And I'll tell you what, I'd hate to be a member of the bomb squad. If I was, I think I'd resign real quick, wouldn't you?
Yes, sir. There he goes, Cary Booth off out of the concrete floor once again. Bob Sweetan.
Turbo Ted telling Cary Booth to go in there and break his arm. Here the fans go again with the USA.
All right.
Sweetan's asking the people, he's setting him up for the pile driver. Oh, Turbo Ted is asking for it. He's asking for it. I'm guaranteeing you this. He's asking for it.
Oh! Well, that backfired.
Cary Booth went to hit Sweetan and knocked Turbo Ted
out. Oh, tremendous clothesline. Sweetan didn't even need
three count.
The pile driver. And Danny Barlow could have counted until they
I'll tell you what. He's like a tore Cary Booth's head off. And Turbo Ted still asking for it. And he's in the ring now.
Uh-oh. Payback.
Turbo Ted's in the ring, and Sweet Tan's got it. Oh, here comes Krupoff, Rose, and Twingle. The whole bomb squad's in there on Sweet Tan, and even Tom Boogaloo Sheriff's getting in on it. Sweet Tan, a man without a country, and I don't know if anybody's going to help him. He keeps getting in these predicaments.
Ascend includes some of today's most popular choruses. Of your favorite praise and worship songs recorded live in stereo. Ascend will help you, heal you. It will lift you into the presence of God and stir the spirit within you. Ascend is available now through the special TV offer for only $9.98. Lyrics are also included with your cassette copy of Ascend to help you sing along. Here's how to order.
Call free 1-800-824-1230. Operators are standing by. Use your MasterCard or Visa or send $9.98 plus $3 shipping and handling to P.O. Box 606, Pensacola, Florida 32501. In Alabama, call 1-456-7495. Call now.
It's pure Chuckwagon Gold, celebrating over 50 years of recording history with 20 gospel greats. Miss your chance to be a part of this celebration.
When we meet our blessed Savior,
the Statler brothers said it best, no one sings like family, and no family sings like the Chuckwagon Gang.
I'm in the way, the bright and shining way. I'm in the glory.
Like Dad Carter said, don't forget the old songs and don't forget the way I taught you to sing them. Here's how to order.
The Chuckwagon Gang's 20 Golden Gospel Greats. Have your credit card ready and call 1-800-453-1800 or send $11.98 plus $2 shipping to 20 Golden Gospel Greats, P.O. Box 606, Pensacola, Florida. This gospel treasury is a must. The immortal sound of the Chuckwagon Gang. 1-800-453-1800.
I'm John McLaughlin with 60 Seconds on Independent Television. Issue, should testing for AIDS be mandatory? Senator Nichols, yes. Representative Schroeder, no.
AIDS should be treated as the deadly, contagious disease it is. We have mandatory and confidential testing programs for every other dangerous disease. AIDS should be no different. Testing is not a cure, but it will provide necessary data for researchers studying the spread of AIDS. It could change a person's habits, making others less at risk, and testing might save someone's life.
Mandatory AIDS testing will not protect public health. Rather, it will drive underground many of those who need medical attention the most because of their fears of discrimination and spend money needed for education and research testing people who aren't at risk. The U.S. Surgeon General is right. With our deficit, education and research are our best weapons against AIDS.
Congress votes on this issue soon. How would you vote?
This independent television presentation is brought to you by Siemens, a group of high-tech companies employing 25,000 Americans in 49 states.
Wrestling fans, at this time, we have Boris Krupoff on the podium with me.
Sweet Tan, I really enjoyed what I did. Let me tell you, I really, really got off on that. In fact, I might have to take a cold shower after this. Never mind a cold shower. I need a cigarette right now. That felt terrific. I don't think that feel terrific. It's getting a $5,000 bounty. That's on your head. But I'm going to make it a little more interesting. Since you love this country so much, Mr. America, I want you to fight me in a loser leave the country match. And let me tell you, I ain't leaving. I'm trying to like it down here, and I'm going to make you leave. I don't know where you'd like to go. There's no other country that smells as bad as this place, or is such stupid, idiot, out of shape, ugly people as here. But knowing you, I'm sure you'll find some piece of trash country to take you in. So if we can, when I get you on Sunday, remember, I'm not the one that's leaving. You're the one that's leaving, you husband. You can go to retirement home and sit in your rocking chair all day, rocking back and forth in front of the window, and you're through. So long, sweet Tan.
Boris Krupoff issuing the challenge to Bob Sweetan. Loser goes home.
You know what? If talk was money, that man would be a wealthy man, I guarantee you. Runs his mouth like a Singer sewing machine. But I'm going to say again, Putney, you got to back all that up. And they hurt Sweetan's arm. I just went back and checked on it. And his arm is hurt. But Sweetan's not down, and he's certainly not out, TJ. Here comes the music. You know who that means.
Oh, yeah.
People holding up signs in the audience, Coastal Connection number one.
Oh, yeah.
In this particular match, David Baxter's supposed to be wrestling Bob Hall, but he's got all three of them in there. He's got all three of the connection in there. And that's the bell to get underway. Let's see if Chuck and Bobby, yeah, they're going to leave a ring. John David Baxter.
And David Baxter. Oh, yeah, tremendous move on David Baxter's part.
Missed on the elbow. Missed on that elbow. You know, this Coastal Connection, I've never seen a bunch of young men. And again, you know, everybody looks back to the wrestler that has looked like Rip Tyler, has weighed 275 pounds and have a big tummy. But these kids, I'll tell you what, they make up with so much. Flying body press. They make up with so much with speed and agility inside that ring. Bob Hall is a competitor that's coming along. I've told you, I told you a few weeks ago, CJ.
Right.
He is. He's a man that is really, really looks like he's put his heart and soul into becoming a first-class professional wrestler. And I can see improvements in him every time I see him on the program.
David Baxter has the armbar on Bob Hall. And the crowd is cheering on David Baxter.
This makes you want to change your name to David, doesn't it?
Oh.
All these nice-looking young ladies out here hollering, go, David, go.
Even before the matches started, they were starting to line up there, Rip.
I'll tell you what, if they start hollering Rip, I might pull my shirt off and head for the ring. I'll tell you what, we have got a packed house here for this, for our studio wrestling. I mean, they're packed in here.
I'd like to remind our wrestling fans in the Pensacola area, wrestling at the Municipal Auditorium every Sunday night, bell time 8:30.
Bell time 8:30 is right, CJ. We're going to start something here in Pensacola that we're going to do all around the area before school starts, and that's how kids get in free when a mama or papa buys a general admission ticket. That's just for general admission, and we have to limit it to two children per parent or per adult. But we want to give the kids a little special treat before the summer's over with. Give them a send-off back to school, you know?
So parents bring their kids down, general admission?
Any children, any kid 11 and under gets in free if mama, papa, either one comes and buys a ticket. Limit two per parent. General admission only.
Here's Bob Hall slinging David Baxter into the ropes. Baxter comes back with a drop kick on Hall. Oh, and he telegraphed that and missed it.
He telegraphed that drop kick, and Bob Hall took advantage of it.
He sure did. Took David Baxter to a two count.
You know, when you drop kick a man and you go up 6 foot tall, okay, and you come down all that body weight, when you kick a man, you kick yourself back to a neutral. But when you don't kick him, the whole weight of your body comes down on your back. And most of the time, you lower back. And that takes something out of you in a hurry.
Tremendous body slam on David Baxter. And Baxter's in there with a ring veteran in Bob Hall. And like you said, Rip.
Bob Hall looks like a man with destiny. I'll tell you what, he is putting it on Baxter. He hooked it in a small package. Hall's outside the ropes. He got out of the ropes and saved himself.
David Baxter still trying to clear the cobwebs off. Oh, and Bob Hall just walked into one. Hell, he walked into another shot from David Baxter. Oh!
Boy, that Baxter's throwing some forearms like his papa used to throw.
they're putting punishment now on Bob Hall. Tremendous European uppercut rip.
Tell you what, this turned out to be one whale of a match, DJ.
Look at Baxter. Oh! Great body slam.
Bob Hall's not ready. He kicked him right off of him. Bob Hall hit him in the midsection, him right.
Whoa! High elevation.
Boy, he put him up right then, didn't he?
Yeah.
Missed. Run that knee. I don't know where he missed it or what he did. Looked like he lost his balance. He may have missed that knee. Got a two count, and the referee is starting for the three. David Baxter's real close to losing the match here on the television if he don't get up and get at it.
Hall just walked into another one. Oh, great drop kick. David Baxter gave it full force into Bob Hall's chest.
People are wanting Baxter to put Hall away, but he's found it pretty difficult, I'll tell you that. Boy, this Tom Boogaloo Shaft, what an old season veteran he is. Boy, I'll tell you what, I watched that first match out here today with him, and he impresses me as a man who can do what he says he can do inside that ring.
Oh, yeah.
With Turbo Ted putting up $5,000, I may go back and get my tie and see if I can't beat Sweet Ted. $5,000, you know, and Ted's not a wealthy man, so somebody's putting up some bread besides Turbo Ted. I'm going to tell you that now. Turbo Ted don't have that kind of money, I don't think.
As Papa Rock and I talked about it in the first match, that's obviously what Turbo Ted was up to the past few weeks when he was being the peacemaker in between Sweetan and Krupoff, and he had this planned all along, Rick.
Well, you know, I assume that the guy's smart enough that he figured ahead, and maybe Bob Sweetan was running kind of a loose organization with a bomb squad, and he just let Turbo Ted go right in and take over. Atomic drop, and that drove Bob Hall back up around his shoulders.
Bob Hall's trying to get his legs on.
Baxter's hurt. He's still hurt. Studio wrestling, I've said 1,000 times, it takes it out of you quicker than any other place in the world. Right in here with all these people jammed up against you, close quarters, not that many people to root you on, although we've got probably 200 or 300 in here today. We've got all we can put in here.
Not to mention the television lights here. I know I'm losing a couple of pounds here, Rip, just watching it. David Baxter
making it rough right now on Bob Hall's leg. Hall's done turned it around into a body scissors. Somebody new, somebody exciting every time you turn a TV set on when you watch World Organization Wrestling.
That's right. That was my first look at Boogaloo, the
Tom Boogaloo Shaft, seasoned veteran, well-known professional wrestler, now contracted with World Organization Wrestling. And I'm going to tell you, whether you like him or don't like him, he's quality talent. And that's what we're after here at World Organization Wrestling, is giving the people the best that we possibly can.
Bob Hall still has David Baxter in the leg scissor.
I'll tell you what, these TV matches are 10-minute time limits, and they've got to have been in there 7 or 8 minutes now. I think Baxter may have taken this match lightly. Looks to me like Bob Hall took it very seriously.
Which goes to show you there, Rip, it's a still learning experience for David Baxter. Never take a professional wrestler lightly.
See, well, let me tell you something, CJ. Anytime a man puts a pair of tights on and gets inside that ring, he is capable and subject to beating a world champion on any given night. All it takes inside that ring is one mistake. It's just exactly like any other professional sport. One mistake and you're beaten. I don't care what your name is.
David Baxter must be trying to figure out what it's going to take.
I think he's about decided that he's got to come up with something to beat Bob Hall.
Yeah.
Brandon, the quarterback drop.
Again.
That may have got him.
Two.
Bob Hall's out.
You have to be impressed with the way Bob
give him
Hall's
his grip
hanging.
And give him his gravy, CJ. He's hanging in there.
Yes, he is. David Baxter has been throwing everything at Bob Hall.
He's thrown everything at him but the kitchen sink, and I'll tell you what, Bob Hall's still there.
Sling into the rope. Another one. High elevation. Is this it? Two counts.
Kicked him out again.
Psychologically, what does that do to David Baxter, Rip?
Well, it knocks him down. I'll tell you, when you give a man your best and he don't stay down, you have to, you know, it's like when you, I used to say when you hit a man and if he didn't fall down, I was going to walk around behind him and see what was holding him up. You know, I'd hit him so hard it'd stop him from feeding in Mobile, Alabama. And he's done hit the man with everything he's got, and the man keeps coming back. And you know what? That'll make you nervous. He's trying for a figure four now, and there goes the bell. And the time limit has expired on this match.
Just about the time he's got Bob Hall in the figure four. TV time limit up.
The time limit has expired. So we'll go ahead and...
Okay, we're going to take some breaks here. We'll be back with more wrestling on World Organization Wrestling.
On tomorrow night at Pensacola Municipal Auditorium, bell time is at 8:30 p.m. World Organization Wrestling presents a great card. On this great card will be a loser-leave-town match between Boris Krupoff and Bob Sweetan. A 10-round boxing match between Donnie Fargo and Huggy Bear Brown. I have on the podium with me at this time Don Fargo and Crazy Mike Diamond.
You know, boxing match. Big deal. So he's going to put some gloves on me, take me out there, and he's going to beat me with a pair of boxing gloves. He's crazy, baby. 100% crazy. I don't know how to box with gloves on, so what am I going to do? I'm going to tell you right now what I'm going to do. I'm going to cheat. I'm going to cheat. That's the only way to win. Crazy knows that. Crazy's going to be in my corner. And I'm going to, the first chance I get, I'm going to cheat and I'm going to beat him because I'm not going to stand and let him beat me around like a pulp. I don't go for that. I've learned one thing. The only way to win is to cheat. It makes no difference how you do it. Just beat the man anyway. Down if you get disqualified, big deal. So they find you a stinking little $50. What's that? That's pocket money, man. They better start finding me more than that because I'm just going to keep getting disqualified. I'm going to cheat. I'm going to run if I see a chance to run and come back and fight another day. And Crazy's right with me. And maybe I'm going to tell you something right now, Huggy Bear. You better be on your toes because you just won't be boxing me. You're going to have to be watching out for Crazy because you don't know what he's going to do from one minute to the next, babe. We're coming down there to beat you. And by gosh, that's exactly what we're going to do. If I have to take the gloves off and beat your head in, I'll do it. If I can't do it that way, I'm sure Crazy will have a way to have me do it. But I am not going to go no 8-5-4-3-2 rounds of you. It's going to be done immediately, baby. I'm going to beat you the only way I know how. Sheep.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we are with Rip's Corner, another edition of Rip's Corner. I'm not going to take up a whole lot of time. I've got with me Bob Holly. And Bob, I know you've sustained an injury in your pursuit for the U.S. heavyweight title, and I know you're mad about it.
That's right, Rip Tyler. You know, there's a lot of things that have been happening. Week after week, I come out here and I try to wrestle a match. Here comes Pat Rose, sticking his nose where it does not belong. Well, I'm getting sick and tired of it. Last Sunday night, these people seen what you did to me, Rose. You put 16 stitches right up here, right on my head. Well, let me tell you something, brother. You got me hot. You got me real hot. And it's the last time, Rose. You know, pursuing the United States heavyweight title, it takes a lot of guts. It takes a lot of energy. Well, I got the energy. Rose, I can swing a chair just as good as you can, brother. So come on down next Sunday night, Pensacola, Florida. That's right. I've got you one more time. And that's all it's going to take, brother, because ain't no more of this going to happen to Bob Holly. Because you're going down. I'm getting that back, Rip.
I hate to say this, and Bob has walked off, and he's mad. But ladies and gentlemen, Bob Holly will not be wrestling. We've got a doctor's certificate that says he's got to have at least 2 weeks off. So Bob will not be in the match. There'll be someone there comfortable to take his spot. Another guest I've got on my Rip's Corner today is the recipient of all this vocal from Bob Holly.
the United States heavyweight champion.
Sunday night, where I busted Bob Holly's head wide open. They was blood laying all around the ring, all in the floor, all in the dressing room, and it was all yours, Bob Holly. It was all yours. I have killed you last Sunday night in Pensacola, and I'm going to do it this week, man. So go ahead and roll that tape, Rip.
We don't have the tape, Pat. I'm not proud of the appearance that happened there, and I'm not proud of anybody that causes that kind of injury in the professional wrestling ring. Now, Bob said he was going to wrestle you. Bob's got 2 weeks off, a doctor's certificate. He doesn't know it. He didn't know it when he did the interview. But I'm going to tell you something, mister. You've lit a fire. And this old fat boy ain't going to burn his shirt to smoke him off of you. Because I'm going to tell you something. You and people like you go around starting this trouble. And then when it comes down on you, you come back and you get this mic and you look these cameras right in the eye and you go to crying. Wait a minute. Look at that camera right there and tell those people you ain't ever going to cry, Pat Rhodes. That's all for today for Rip Corner. We'll catch you later on down the road.
Martha Lack for BC Powder.
I've got 53 children.
When you really care.
And it's up to me to feed them every single day.
And you have to be there.
When the work brings on a big boom of a headache, I reach for BC Headache Powder.
That's the time to take BC.
BC's fast, and I need something that works quick to keep me going.
When the pain keeps growing, but you've got to keep going.
These animals are depending on me.
That's the time to take BC.
Also an arthritis strength.
People sharing Jesus, touching hearts each day.
We invite you to worship with us here at Dauphin Way Baptist Church every Sunday morning at 11 o'clock with our pastor, Dr. Daryl Robinson.
People sharing Jesus.
World Organization Wrestling at the Pensacola Municipal Auditorium tomorrow night. We have some great matches planned for you. A loser leaves town match featuring Boris Krupoff and Bruiser Bob Sweetan. Also on that card, 10 rounds of boxing, Don Fargo versus Huggy Bear Brown, and the World Organization Wrestling United States Heavyweight Championship title bout will be featuring Pat Rhodes and Bob Holly. And Bob Holly, this is your chance.
That's right, CJ. You know, all these people last Sunday night seen what Pat Rhodes had done to me. All right, I went to the hospital. I got 16 stitches in my head and a slight concussion. The doctor advised me not to wrestle, to lay off for a while. But tomorrow night in Pensacola, Florida, downtown at the auditorium, Pat Rhodes, I got a big surprise for you, a real big surprise. I'm not going to say what it is, but I have somebody to take care of business. I won't be able to wrestle because the doctor advised me not to, so I'm going to take his advice. But I have a real big surprise for you.
Bob Sweetan, you've got your shot at Boris Krupoff tomorrow night.
Krupoff, take a good look at his arm. You tried your darnest to break it, didn't you, Krupoff? Why? Because you're a little nervous about this match? Turbo Ted, you get up here in your monkey suit and you rant and rave and stutter and blubber like an idiot that you are. Well, let me tell you something. You may have everybody's contract. You may have everybody in your hip pocket, but this good old American boy doesn't fit in anybody's hip pocket. You try to bust my arm, you try to put me out of the sport of professional wrestling. Let me tell you something, Krupoff. You bit off more than you can chew, boy. I don't care how tough or how bad they make them in Russia. When you step in the ring here tomorrow night, you're stepping in the ring with an American. And I don't take a back seat to nobody. Least of all you, Krupoff. You've bit it off. Now try and chew it, because I'm going to come at you with everything and I'm not going to stop.
Donnybrook in there. Look at this. What? What started out, and what I think is going to start out, is a tag team match with Wild Man Don Fargo and Crazy Mike Diamond. taking on Huggy Bear Brown. And a new face to World Organization Wrestling, Surfer Joe Fisher. Here we go. Huggy Bear Brown. Arm drags. Crazy Mike Diamond to the canvas. Makes the tag. Surfer Joe Fisher.
All right, CJ, look like my mic don't want to work. Joe Fisher, Huggy Bear Brown, Crazy Mike Diamond, and Don Fargo. And this is going to be one terrific match.
Referee in there has got his hands full. He's got to get some kind of order. Wild man Don Fargo working over Surfer Joe Fisher. Wrestlers in there now are Crazy Mike Diamond. Makes the tag. Teamwork of Wild Man Don Fargo, Crazy Mike Diamond. Hey, whether you agree with the methods of the Wild Man and the Crazy Man, they still get the job done. They get the results.
Well, there's the tag is being made. Maybe more down comes in now, CJ. You know, they always have had this thing between Don Fargo and Huggy Bear Brown. So this is going to be one terrific match here on World Organization Wrestling. This is the first time we've had the opportunity of seeing Joe Fisher.
Young wrestler. Doesn't have the weight that the majority of these wrestlers have. However, again, he's got the speed, the agility, and the quickness, which is very important. Oh, Wild Man Don Fargo takes Huggy Bear Brown, and Huggy Bear goes hard on the canvas, off the canvas and on the concrete floor. Oh, tremendous shot. Wild Man Don Fargo just laid into Surfer Joe Fisher. It is broken loose, and Wild Man Don Fargo just laid one into the referee. Going to get a little bit of help. Danny Barlow was in there. And Danny Barlow just took one. This match is going to end in a disqualification. That's going to do it for this week's edition of World Organization Wrestling. We want to see you here again next week. Some more great action on the way. So stay tuned. World Organization Wrestling coming up for you next week. Until then, I'm CJ Whitmore, Papa Rock, and Rip Tyler.